Hello students, in the first part of the video we have done our first chapter of maths, that is numbers and numerations. In the first part of the video we have discussed the topics place value, how to write the number names, expanded form, Indian and the international place value system, and I have also given you a very short assignment to done. I hope you all have done that. Now we proceed further. Now today we'll do the next topic, that is comparison of Indian and the international place value system. As you can see in this table, what we have observed in this table, this is according to the Indian place value system and this is according to the international place value system. As we have done already, that in the Indian place value system there are four periods, that is ones, thousand, lakh and crores. And in ones period there are three places, ones, tens, hundred, and in thousand there are two places, that is thousands and 10,000. Similarly, in lakh period there are two places, lakhs and 10 lakhs, and in crores also crore and 10 crore. In the international place value system there are three periods, ones, thousand and millions. In the ones period we have the three places, ones, tens and hundred. In the thousand period we have three places, 1,000, 10,000 and 100,000. And in millions period we have three places, millions, 10 millions and 100 millions. What we observe from this table, that up to the first five places there is no difference. Up to 10,000 it is same in the both system, that is Indian and the international system. And after that there are changes. And what we observe from these changes, that when we see at that 10 crores, where is written 10 crores? It is written as 10 crores. 10 crores is equals to the 100 millions. Similarly, 1 crore. 1 crore is equal to 10 millions. 10 lakh. 10 lakh is equals to 1 million. And 1 lakh is equal to 100,000. To learn this table and to understand these values, if you try to make this table by yourself, you will understand it more better. Now we talk about the face and place value of a number. For example, I have taken one example to explain you this, 1723. If we want to tell the face value of a number, face value of a digit is always the digit itself. It does not depend upon the place. Means if I have to tell the face value of 7, means the face value of 7 is 7. Means it does not depend upon the place, it is always the number itself. Like the place face value of 2, face value of 2 is 2. Face value of 3, it is 3. And if I have to tell the place value of the 7, as we have already done that thing earlier, that the place value of 7, we have always, I already told you about that, to tell the place value, we always count the digits after that number. There are two digits after the 7, so we'll write here 7 and two digits, so the place value of the 7 is 700. And one more important point I want to tell you, that the number 0, whenever we have to tell you the place value of 0, place value of 0, it is always 0, because it does not depend upon the place it occupies. The place value of 0, it is 0, and also the face value of 0 is 0. You have to remind these two points, that the place value of 0, it is 0, and the face value of 0 is always 0. I want to discuss one question with you. If you get any question like this, that the difference of the place value of 2 fives in this number. Suppose you are given this number. In this number, we see that there are 2 5. And in question, they have asked us about the difference of the place value. As we have already done, how to find the place value. To find the place value of this digit number, what we have done? 5. Digits after the 5 is 2. So, place value of this number is 500. Similarly, the place value of this 5 is this. As they have asked us here, the difference. So, what we will do? We will subtract the place value of these two 5s and we will get this answer. You can get this sum as a, in spite of the difference, you can also get here as a sum. You can also get here that sum of the place values of two 5s in this number. If you will get as a sum, so you have to write here the sum.
So in this way you will do addition here, and if you will get here to find the product, and if you will get here to be get the product, so again here you also have to done the product of those two place values, means you have to multiply those place value of two numbers.
Now we do the comparison of the numbers. We can compare the numbers by two ways. I'm telling you by giving some examples. Like in example ones, I have given you two numbers. You have to compare these numbers. Your first one thing is that number with more digits is greater. Firstly, you will count the digits. Like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is a 6 digit number. This is a 6 digit number. And another one is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. This is a 7 digit number. So, the number with the more digits will always be the greater. This is the first type how you can compare a number by counting the digits. The digit with the more number will be the greater one. Now come to the second type. Here I have taken two numbers. Here firstly we count the digits. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. These both are the 6 digit numbers. This is a 6 digit number and this is also a 6 digit number. Now both are the number same. Now we start comparing the numbers. Like here the first digit is 3. Here is also 3. This is 5. This is also 5. But here it is 7 and this is 8. Now we'll compare that this is 7,000 and this is 8,000. So 8,000 is greater than 7, so this number will be the greater. These are the two ways how you can compare the numbers. Now talk about the successor and predecessor of a number. To write the successor of a number, we'll add 1 to the given number. And to write the predecessor of a number, we'll subtract 1 from the given number. Suppose 362 is our given number. To write the successor of this number, our given number is 362. And if we add 1 to it, it will become 363. So this is the successor of this number. And if we have to write the predecessor of the given number, what we will do? Given number is 362. We'll subtract 1 from it and we will get 361. This is the predecessor of this number. Now we tell about the formation of the greatest and smallest number. Suppose you are given these 6 digits. Means you can form a 6 digit number by using these numbers. So to get a greatest number, we arrange these digits in the descending order. We know about descending order. In descending order, we arrange the numbers from biggest to smallest. Same thing we do, that in descending order, we arrange the numbers from biggest to the smallest. So we start arranging them 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 1. So this is the greatest 6 digit number which we have formed by using these digits. To form a smallest number, we arrange the digits in the ascending order. Ascending order is from smallest to the biggest number. So the number formed will be 1, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. This is the way we can form the digits. By using these digits, we can form a greatest and a smallest number. Now, if you are given the digits in this way, that is 1, 2, 3, 5, 7, 8. You can count these digits 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is the 6 digits. 6 digits are given you. But you are told to form a 7 digit number. Then how you will make that number, that I will tell you. Suppose you are given to make a greatest 7 digit number. Now you have to form a greatest 7 digit number by using these digits. You know that to form a greatest 7 digit number, as we have done in the last example, you have to arrange these digits in the descending order. Descending order will be 9, 7, 5, 3, 2, 1. But this is a 6 digit number. But you have to form a 7 digit number. So we'll repeat the
first digit means 9. If it is given you that you can repeat the digits, then what you will do? You will repeat the first digit, then you will get the greatest 7 digit number. If you tell to ask the smallest, you are told to form the smallest 7 digit number. What you will do? To form the smallest, what we do? We arrange these numbers in the ascending order. Ascending order means 1, 2, 3, 5, 7, 9. But this is a 6 digit number. So as to form it a 7 digit number, we will repeat the first digit, that is 1. Now it is a 7 digit number. In this way, you can form the digits. You can form a number by using the digits, whether with repetition or without repetition.
Now I'm giving you a home assignment on based on what we have done today. Question number 1 is, find the place value of the 0 in this question. Second one, find the sum of place values of 3 9s in the number this. As I have given you an example today, in that question I have told you about the difference of the place value, but here you have to done the sum of place values. Question 3rd, write the predecessor and the successor of these two numbers. 4th question is, you can compare by using these signs. 5th one is, write the smallest and the largest 7 digit number using these, and you may repeat a digit. Now 1st chapter of our maths is completed, and thank you.